Hey, this is Al Dawson from Earache Records, and we are actually celebrating our 30th year this year. So we're going to talk about some behind the scenes moments of some of the classic records that came out on Earache. So Napalm Death was the third release on Earache. Napalm Death Scum, which is a compilation of Side A and Side B, were two different lineups of Napalm Death. Side A was Mickey Harris and Nick Bullen and Justin Broderick, and Side B was Lee Dorian and Bill Steer and Mickey Harris on drums. And they did a tour of Japan in, I want to say, 1989. And after that tour, Lee Dorian left the band and Bill Steer left the band. To be fair, Bill already had a rough working of Carcass going at the time, and he's like, I want to do my thing. And Lee had a real problem at the time with the popularity that Napalm, I mean, he even says to this day now, like, I was such a plonker or whatever, because he wouldn't be happy if they were charging more than, say, £5 a show type of thing. Like, greedy corporate rock stars or whatever. He looks back now and cringes or what have you. But at the time, that was an important thing for him. Like, we've lost our roots of what the band was about and all that. So he went on to form Cathedral. But from that core Napalm imploding, or whatever you want to say, Mick and Nick went on to do Scorn. Shane obviously is still with the band to this day. Lee went on to do Cathedral. Bill went on to do Carcass. And a lot of the original spark of the label was built on that implosion and people going on and doing new things from there and being supportive of those artists. Like Digby always says, you got to go where the talent goes. And when you have so many characters in the band, by supporting Lee, by supporting Bill, those things exploded as well. So Cathedral, first record they did was super slow and super heavy and dark, which you want to say these days is a doom resurgence, but 1990 or 1991, Lee had left Napalm Death, and again, this is before the internet, so the exchange of information, you'd have to read fine print of every magazine to know everything that's going on, because, you know, he went from the world's fastest band, Napalm Death. Everyone's expecting Napalm Death Part 2. So for him as a vocalist and what he wanted to do was doom. And we got a lot of hate mail after the record came out going, what the hell is this crap? Like, he's going slow. But from that, it definitely helped the doom resurgence on the back of that record. But again, after Forest of Equilibrium, the next record, The Ethereal Mirror, was a little more accessible, a little more upbeat than the first record. Again, we got hate mail from people because there was a certain chunk of people who all of a sudden got what Cathedral was, and they felt that that record was, I mean, I think we got accused of putting out Poison. But, you know, again, you can't please everybody, and then I guess over years, people go back and discover the record and realize what he was doing and appreciate it more. But we definitely had some hate mail at the time.